Blessed be the one holy and living God. Glory to God forever and ever. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. Jesus Christ with the Holy Spirit in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
God be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Set us free, O God, from the bondage of our sins, and give us the liberty of that abundant life which you made known to us in your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Isaiah. Have you not known? Have you not heard? Has it not been told you from the beginning? Have you not understood from the foundations of the earth? It is he who sits above the circle of the earth, and its inhabitants are like grasshoppers. Who stretches out the heavens like a curtain and spreads them like a tent to live in? Who brings princes to naught and makes the rulers of earth as nothing? Scarcely are they planted, scarcely sown, scarcely has their stem taken root in the earth. When he blows upon them, and they wither, and the tempest carries them off like stubble. To whom then will you compare me, and who is my equal, says the Holy One? Lift up your eyes on high and see. Who created these? He who brings out their host and numbers them, calling them all by name. Because he is great in strength, mighty in power, not one is missing. Why do you say, O Jacob, and speak, O Israel? My way is hidden from the Lord, and my right is disregarded by my God. Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint and strengthens the powerless. Even youths will faint and be weary, and the young will fall exhausted. But those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Let us read Psalm 147 in unison. Hallelujah. How good it is to sing praises to our God. How pleasant it is to honor him with praise. The Lord rebuilds Jerusalem. He gathers the exiles of Israel. He heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wounds. He counts the numbers of the stars and calls them all by their names. Great is our Lord and mighty in power. There is no limit to his wisdom. The Lord lifts up the lowly, but it casts the wicked to the ground. Sing to the Lord with thanksgiving. Make music to our God upon the harp. He covers the heavens with clouds and prepares rain for the earth. He makes grass to grow up on the mountains and green plants to serve mankind. He provides food for flocks and herds and for the young ravens when they cry. He is not impressed by the might of a horse. He has no pleasure in the strength of a man. But the Lord has pleasure in those who fear him and those who await his gracious favor. Hallelujah.
A reading from the second letter of Paul to the Corinthians. If I proclaim the gospel, this gives me no ground for boasting, for an obligation is laid on me, and woe to me if I do not proclaim it. For if I do this of my own will, I have a reward, but if not of my own will, I am entrusted with a commission. What then is my reward? Just this, that in my proclamation I may make the gospel free of charge so as not to make full use of my rights in the gospel. For though I am free with respect to all, I have made myself a slave to all so that I might win more people. To the Jews I became as a Jew in order to win Jews. To those under the law I became as one under the law, though I myself am not under the law, so that I might win those under the law. To those outside the law, I became as one outside the law, though I am not free from God's law, but am under Christ's law, so that I might win those outside the law. To the weak, I became weak, so that I might win the weak. I have become all things to all people, that I might by all means save some. I do it all for the sake of the gospel, so that I may share in its blessings. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
I agree. Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Mark. Glory to you, O Christ. When Jesus and his disciples left the synagogue, they entered the house of Simon and Andrew with James and John. Now Simon's mother-in-law was in bed with a fever, and they told him about her at once. He came and took her by the hand and lifted her up. Then the fever left, and she began to serve them. That evening, at sundown, they brought to him all who were sick or possessed with demons, and the whole city was gathered around the door. And he cured many who were sick with various diseases and cast out many demons. And he would not permit the demons to speak because they knew him. In the morning, while it was still dark, he got up at once to a deserted place, and there he prayed. And Simon and his companions hunted for him. When they found him, they said to him, "Everyone is searching for you." He answered, "Let us go on to the neighboring towns, so that I may proclaim the message there also. For that is what I came out to do." And he went throughout Galilee, proclaiming the message in their synagogues and casting out demons. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. The 40th chapter of the book of Isaiah is one of my most cherished chapters in the entire Bible. It begins with the well-known words, "Comfort, O comfort my people, says the Lord." We know these words not only from Scripture, but also from music. If you're part of the Episcopal tradition, you've likely sung hymn number 67 every Advent. "Comfort, comfort ye my people, speak ye peace, thus saith our God. Comfort those who sit in darkness, mourning neath their sorrow's load. Speak ye to Jerusalem of the peace that waits for them. Tell her that her sins I cover, and her warfare now is over." Even George Frederick Handel used these verses in the first part of his Messiah. How could you not love this hymn, this chapter, this entire section known as 2nd Isaiah? Isaiah chapters 40 through 55 address tired and weary Judeans who have lived in exile for a couple generations now. They have the opportunity to return home to Jerusalem from exile in Babylon. But the thing is, their home doesn't exist anymore. In Jerusalem, the temple has been demolished. Their houses are in ruins. They are depressed. They're apathetic and hopeless. They struggle to imagine a new future in their old home. We hear them question Isaiah. Why should we go back? How do we know God is still with us after decades and decades of exile? Could we ever live freely again? Could we ever live with hope again? 2nd Isaiah speaks directly to these exiled Israelites. The prophet urges them to live in hope. He offers encouragement to go home. He describes the peace awaiting them once they arrive back in Jerusalem. We hear Isaiah saying the words that we know best from John the Baptizer. "In the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God." Here, Isaiah is calling for a desert highway to be built for their easy return. But the people, even the young people, doubt that they have the strength to make the journey. Today, we hear the words, "Even youths will faint and be weary, and the young will fall exhausted. They are in a dark place. And what started as a gentle pastoral response from Isaiah, "Comfort, O comfort my people," has turned in to pleading, insistent questions. Have you not known? Have you not heard? Has it not been told to you from the beginning? Isaiah implores the Israelites to look back on their history with God as a chosen people. Think about what initially drew you into relationship with God, and knowing how impossible it can be to think creatively in the midst of depression, Isaiah then paints a picture for them of their loving, powerful, sovereign God. He describes God's creative power that will make this prophetic vision a reality. Isaiah describes a God who sits above the circle of the earth. There's no deity in all of Babylon that could possibly be God's equal. Political and military authorities might seem powerful, yet God is sovereign over them as well. The Babylonians, who exert power over the captive Israelites, are no match for God. They are, we're told today, like plants that a strong wind could blow over. Isaiah says that God need not even touch the political leaders to defeat them. God must simply blow upon them and they wither. God stands alone. There's no match on heaven or on earth. And yet, as powerful as God is equally as loving. God will provide the energy needed to bring the people home. God offers strength to every person whose despair has left them exhausted, allowing them to run, not be weary, to walk, and not faint. The exiles might be tired. They might be weary, powerless, and faint. But God is not. Can you now imagine a future in which you yourself are not weary? A future in which we can be in crowded places, like churches or restaurants or airplanes, and not feel anxious or scared. I didn't realize how deeply I craved Isaiah chapter 40 until this week. I read beginning with verse 1, and then just kept going through chapter 55. I felt as if I sank into these words. I'm so tired, even though I'm sleeping enough. I'm so weary, even though I'm praying enough. There are days when I've been crippled with anxiety, even though I'm sure enough of God's love and God's faithfulness. I feel mentally and emotionally weary. How long, O Lord, will this continue? How long must I wait to lay hands upon the sick members of my church family and pray for their healing? How long must we wait to share the peace of God through hugs and hearty handshakes? How long before businesses open and thrive once again? How long, O Lord? Of course, I find signs of hope and grace all the time, and yet there are these days in which I'm reminded of how little control I have over the future. I feel displaced from friends, from my extended family, from my church family, almost like an exile in a faraway land. Are you feeling the same exhaustion? I invite you to hear the words of God spoken through the prophet Isaiah. They who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. They who wait upon the Lord. Who wait upon the Lord. Well, we're good at waiting in the Episcopal Diocese of Fort Worth. We've been waiting a decade for resolution in a lawsuit, only to be told last week that we must wait a little bit more for the next decision. We've been waiting to return to our church buildings for 11 months, and it appears that there's more to endure. We're called to continue waiting, but to continue waiting on the Lord. This waiting is an act of faith. It's to hope and to expect that God will do for the exiles what God did for creation, that God will give life where there was no life at all. Isaiah tells us God is great in strength, mighty in power. God's strength and power are poured out for God's people in love, always in love. God fulfills this promise for the Hebrew exiles, strengthening them to walk along the wilderness back home, and then strengthening them yet again for the rebuilding of the nation. So right now, as we wait upon God, I have hope that God is taking our weariness and offering us divine strength. Where will we go with this divine strength? We want to return to normalcy. We want to return home. Isaiah encourages the displaced Israelites to look back to Jerusalem, but really, Isaiah encourages them to follow God to some place new. In chapter 43, verses 18 and 19, God tells the exiles, "Do not remember the former things or consider the things of old. I am about to do a new thing." They may go home, but everything will be different. They won't be going back. They're really moving forward into God's new thing, God's new creation. We as the church won't be going back to how things were. We can't. Too much has changed since our churches left their buildings in March of 2020. There's the pandemic, the economic crisis, the changes in national politics, the public unveiling of violent white Christian nationalism. So much has happened. We as the church can't go back to anything. Like the exiled Israelites, we can only go forward, moving into God's new creation, to God's new thing. I don't know what it will look like, but the chapters of 2 Isaiah call us to reflect upon God's creative power, to trust that God intrinsically knows us and our deepest needs, that God can provide us with a highway in the most desolate of deserts. God can provide us the strength to walk and even run along it. So when we return to our buildings, we will not be going back to how things were, but we will be equipped with God's strength to embody God's truth and love to the world around us. I think that this means publicly striving for justice and peace. It means publicly respecting the dignity of all people. This means challenging all forces of evil and oppression and contributing to the shaping of a new future. I don't know what's in store, but I know that we won't be going back. We'll be moving forward, and God will be with us. Amen.
Let us join our voices now with believers around the world as we proclaim our faith as expressed in the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made human. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshiped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray for the church and the world.
Almighty God, grant that all who confess your name may be united in your truth, live together in your love, and reveal your glory in the world. We pray for Justin, the Archbishop of Canterbury, Michael, the presiding bishop of the Episcopal Church, Scott, our bishop, and for all bishops, ministers, and lay leaders. Christ, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Guide the people of this land and of all the nations in the ways of justice and peace, especially Joe, our president, Kamala, our vice president, Greg, our governor, Betsy, our mayor, that we may honor one another and serve the common good. Christ, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give us all a reverence for the earth as your own creation, that we may use its resources rightly in the service of others and to your honor and glory. Christ, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Bless all whose lives are closely linked with ours, and grant that we may serve Christ in them and love one another as he loves us. We pray for Four Saints Episcopal Food Pantry, Eastside Ministries, and other nonprofit organizations caring for your beloved. Christ, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Joy of human hearts, heal our communities, especially those where your word is not heard, or where neglect, violence, greed, and warfare increase the suffering and the need of people and all other creatures. Protect and guide those who serve in the military and those who are first responders. Christ, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Comforter of all the earth, bless those worshiping with us today and any looking for a place to belong. Sustain the people who need your presence and help, especially those we now name.
Karen, David, Jennifer, Melissa,
Selma,
Barbara, Judy.
Christ, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We commend to your mercy all who have died, that your will for them may be fulfilled. And we pray that we may share with all your saints in your eternal kingdom. Christ, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. Almighty and eternal God, ruler of all things in heaven and earth, mercifully accept the prayers of your people and strengthen us to do your will. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. Amen. Let us pray also for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful God. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone, and so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through the grace of Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, together we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The peace of Christ be always with you. And the blessing of God Almighty, Creator, Redeemer, and Sanctifier, rest upon you and remain with you always. Amen. Let us go forth rejoicing in the power of the Spirit. Thanks be to God.